and welcome to this introduction to Pro R, the FabFilter reverb plugin. With a beautiful and ergonomic interface in the trademark FabFilter style, Pro R features a control set specially designed to make it as easy as possible to dial in your reverb using musically relevant terms such as brightness, or distance, or stereo width. The graph below provides real-time analysis of the output with a FabFilter style EQ to shape the reverb signal. While the blue decay rate EQ curve above provides unique control over reverb decay time, allowing you to lengthen or shorten specific frequencies by dragging nodes around like an EQ. This goes way beyond the traditional crossover approach, both in terms of the sonic possibilities it provides and in the ease with which it allows you to dial in different colours of reverb. And of course, the sound quality is pristine, with algorithms carefully designed to blend well with the source and fit easily into a mix. Let's start by turning down the mix knob to listen to the dry signal, which was recorded with just a pair of mics placed under the lid of the piano. And now let's try loading a concert hall type preset from the menu at the top. If you click the lock button for the mix knob, you can avoid changing the balance of wet and dry signal while browsing presets. Or avoid adding any dry signal at all if you're running the reverb as a send effect. So let's load the default preset and dial in a sound from scratch. The large space knob replaces the usual choice of different algorithms and sweeps continuously from tiny spaces and small rooms. Through to medium and large rooms. Halls, churches and cathedrals. While the decay rate knob to the right allows you to vary the reverb time without changing the room model. The distance knob controls the front to back depth of the sound, allowing you to move the source towards the foreground or the background of your virtual space. Turn it down to bring the source closer, with lots of early reflections to provide presence and clarity. Or turn it up to put more emphasis on the late stage and change the way that the early reflections blend into the tail. Of course, we also have a more traditional pre-delay parameter at the bottom, which can be set to tempo sync to beat divisions if required. The character knob allows you to change the style of the reverb. The clean setting provides a dense, smooth reverb tail with no modulation. While turning it up towards the lively setting adds subtle echoes and reflections to the tail and introduces some gentle random modulation. Above the halfway point, modulation starts to become stronger and more chorusy, reminiscent of vintage digital reverb units, and the sound starts to become more unreal and more dreamy. Let's switch to a different example. This lovely Rhodes piano was recorded straight from a DI box and is as dry as it can get. So let's add some space with Pro R. This time I'm going to turn up the brightness knob, which does just what it says in a very intuitive manner. And I'm going to explore the upper reaches of the character knob, where the modulation starts to become quite obvious. With small room settings, we can create rich, lush sounding effects that sit somewhere between chorus and reverb. The stereo width knob controls cross feedback and width, and goes right down to mono if required. Though there is also a mono version of the plug if you need to insert it on a mono channel. When width is set to 100%, there's almost no cross feedback, and the sound is very wide and spacious. Settings above 100% further boost the differences between left and right channels for an unnaturally wide reverb that will get slightly quieter when folded down to mono, so you can create a wide, spacious reverb effect that doesn't clutter up the mono version of your mix too much. Okay, let's try a snare drum. I'll go for a medium-sized room and set the brightness up a bit higher. And I'll drag to select all bands for both graphs and delete them so we can dial in the reverb colour from scratch. I'll drag in a boost for the blue decay rate EQ to begin with, and I'll tune it round about the low fundamental of the drum, using my mouse wheel to adjust the width. So the reverb blooms a little longer at those frequencies and makes the drum seem a bit fatter. And maybe I'll also grab an EQ band on the yellow graph and dial down that region a bit to stop it becoming congested. And I can select both these nodes and tune them together if needed. If I drag in from the right, I can add a high shelving type band. Boosting the decay time for the higher frequencies makes the reverb start to sound a bit splashy. So I'll damp that region down instead, and shorten the decay for the treble and high mid-range. And I might also double-click the right-hand side of the yellow EQ curve to add a high cut filter, and gently roll off the very highest frequencies for a slightly darker room sound. If I put this in with the rest of the close mics and the overheads, and ride the reverb return channel up and down, we can hear how well Pro-R blends into the drum mix. The reverb makes the snare sound bigger and wider, but doesn't colour the dry sound of the snare drum, or sound artificially stuck on top. Now let's try some conga close mics. I'll start with a reasonably bright sound once again, with a moderately large room size. But this time I'll also dial the character knob all the way down to remove any hint of discrete echoes and create a dense, smoothly decaying tail. Now I'll drag in from the left of the decay time EQ curve and damp down the low frequency decay time with a low shelving band to help prevent the low end of the congas cluttering the mix. And I'll lengthen the reverb for the mid frequencies instead to bring out those complex overtones. And maybe I'll turn up the distance knob a touch to move the percussion a little further back in the soundstage. So let's try a vocal for the last example. Many modern productions mix vocals apparently dry with no obvious reverb effect. But keeping your vocal totally dry can often make it sound like it's stuck on top and disconnected from the rest of the mix. So let's add some reverb from Pro-R with a tiny small space setting and distance turned right down. And notice how much better the vocal now sits in the mix. Monte Carlo, money, Monte Carlo. Bram Stoker fable on your poker table. I start switching like Jose Conseco, screaming or the Le Pendejo. You think you're hot because you got the Mr. Muscle. When it comes to trouble, but they split quicker than ripple shuffles like aces, cases, knocking over. We can now dial in different colours of ambience to change the emotional impact of the vocal. We can make it sound warmer and more intimate. Or richer and thicker when the character knob is turned above halfway. Or brighter and glossier. And if sibilance becomes a problem, it's easy to damp that region down and shorten the decay time for the sibilant region. Or even put in a notch and stop that region dead. Okay, that's all for now. As usual, you can open the user manual via the help menu at the top if you need more information. Or you can show interactive help hints and get a pop-up description of each control you hover over. Thanks for watching.